What's up, guys? It's November 25th, 2018. It's Frosty the Songman from Red Radio Reviews. And today, in 1968, November 25th, the Beatles' White Album was released in the U.S. And I have it right here. I've bought all the Beatles albums at some point in my life, although I've lost a few, so I probably have about half of them at this point. It's a good album. Most of the Beatles albums are good. As people know, they're pretty famous, you know. All right, in 1974, UK singer Nick Drake died in his sleep, age 26, of an overdose of tryptosol and an antidepressant drug. I was going to have the CD ready. I forgot to get it. Let me see. Here's a Nick Drake. Yeah, here's two of them. That's his most famous one, Pink Moon. Very good. Very good album. And another one is Five Leaves Left, which is also very good. I recommend both of those, actually. Kind of melancholy UK folky brooding type stuff. Alright, 1976, the band made their final performance. The Last Waltz was held on Thanksgiving Day at Winterland Ballroom in San Francisco. I probably have the band too somewhere. There's Bob Dylan. It's pretty close. The band. Here's the best of the band. It's a great album, needless to say. I don't know. There might be another band album down there. But anyway, I like the band a lot. I actually saw The Last Waltz, and it's worth seeing. It's a really cool documentary made by Scorsese. All right, in 2003, Meatloaf underwent surgery in a London hospital after being diagnosed with a condition that causes an irregular heartbeat. And all right, with that, tonight I'm going to review an album. I don't even have the cover for it. I lost it somewhere along the way. But it is Pete Townsend's White City, a novel. And this is what the album cover looks like. Stop that from wobbling. That's the album cover, if you're interested. So it was a concept album. Pete Townsend is really into concept albums. Like he did Tommy. I mean, he was the main force behind Tommy, The Who's Tommy. Quadrophenia, he was the main force behind that, which I think was originally going to be called Lifehouse, maybe, if I remember right. Anyway, he likes concept albums, and so do I. I like a lot of Kinks concept albums and Pink Floyd albums. So I'm a big fan of concept albums too. And there goes my dehumidifier. I can't even reach it. So there's my black cat. So yeah, this was released in November 1985, and I remember getting it when it came out. I was a Who fan back then, and Pete Townsend fan too, so I picked this album, the CD, up. And this is actually the original CD I got back in the 1980s. You know, it's been a long time since the 80s, so you know, you're gonna lose a album cover from way back then every once in a while. The story of this album takes place in a low-income housing estate in the West London district of White City, which I was actually in probably 15 years ago. I went to visit London, and we went through White City. It's not very remarkable. It's just a bunch of dreary, dull apartments and empty streets and... Yeah, and we went in winter too, so that didn't help. It was just this desolate nothingness there. I mean, there's nothing that seemed like it was worth going there for. And Pete Townsend grew up near there, near White City. And the songs talk about racial tension, cultural conflict, hopes and dreams of young people in the 1960s. Pete Townsend sings about White City being a violent place, you know, a lot of conflict going on. And actually, when I was preparing for this review, I just found out about, there's a 60-minute film by Richard Lowenstein entitled White City, the Music Movie. And it was released also in 1985, the same year as this album, and features Pete Townsend, Andrew Wilde, and Francis Barber. And I was kind of, I went online to see some of the video, and it seems pretty cool. Seems like a lot of images from London and White City, and the band playing. At some point, they're playing in front of a swimming pool, which is kind of weird. But I plan on getting the video. It looks kind of cool. I'm a glutton for anything like English rock, British rock. I'm a big fan of. So check that movie out. It's called White City, the Music Movie. One of the songs of the album, White City Fighting, originated as a composition by David Gilmour of Pink Floyd. And it was written for his second album, About Face, which I don't have. I think I take these out and put them in my these little binders with CDs, and I don't ever put them back. But anyway, that's the back of the album, if you're interested. And David Gilmour's About Face. This is a decent album. This is 1984, so this came out right before White City. Anyway, Townsend wrote lyrics for it, and Gilmour couldn't really connect to the lyrics, so he was like, well, why don't you just have the song? So Pete Townsend took the song for this White City album. He couldn't really relate to the lyrics. Townsend. But Gilmour actually played on Pete's album. So he's playing guitar in White City Fighting, which you're going to hear really soon here. The first song on the album is Give Blood. Let me try to play this. I've got this playing through my computer. So, of course, it's not queued up because I'm about as unprofessional as they get. Here it goes. Let me turn it up. It's a really cool song. It's got Simon Phillips on drums. Very nice. Very nice drummer. I was a drummer. I mean, I still play drums, but when I was really learning drums, this is one of the albums I listened to. And I remember Simon Phillips being on the cover of Modern Drummer, and I really used to respect him a lot. He's got these cool grooves. Anyway, that's a really cool song. And it really explodes in the end. Like, it's got this kind of rocking section where it really opens up. Nice fretless bass there. Anyway, cool song. All right, let me go to the next song. The next song is this is Face to Face. It's actually the third song. I got it in the wrong order. Let me turn this up. This has got the big band and kind of a different tune. It's more of a swinging big band tune. But it's cool. It's a cool tune.
We got to find a face. Face to face. Stop the trip. Face to face. watch the flicks.
Pete Townsend's one of the greatest. You have to agree with me there, or else unsubscribe to my channel. Alright, this tune I really dig. It's called The Brilliant Blues. Sound.
Take me. It's time.
Lock and spiel, which is always a hit.
To give.
No pun intended.
So don't betray me. Pay me. The brilliant blues. Don't wanna be frozen. I spend my mornings at the sunshine.
I really like that song. It's nothing wrong with it whatsoever. It's like a perfect song. This is called Hiding Out. Kind of a exotic feel to it. Cool feel. Alright, so next we have Crashing by Design.
Crashing by Design. You won't believe the crazy accident will happen to you. You were chasing a capricious wind. Whatever bad luck and trouble happened to pursue you, the dust should have saved you. Just have to be resigned. You're crashing by design. And you sit on the back of the car, building.
So, really cool stuff. I mean, yeah, it's dated. It's definitely 80s sounding, but, you know, you can't deny it's really great music. This is a really nice one.
By awakening faces, I see the panic of people in motion. I can stand here, look out on an ocean. I am a wall awaiting a catchword. I see the city laid out like a patchwork.
Almost sounds like Black Waterside by Zeppelin, which was a cover tune.
I hope that this life is frozen and timeless.
This is one of my favorite tunes on the album. That meow wasn't in the song. There's actually this guy. Yeah. Yeah, it was that guy. It wasn't actually in the tune. Although that could have been cool. Meow. Placed right at the right spot, it could be very effective. Alright, there's a couple more. Let me just play White City Fighting. This is one of my favorites too. It's got an awesome groove to it. This is the one Dave Gilmore plays on. This almost sounds like Hey You from The Wall.
Thank you.
City Fighting. The White City Fighting. Remember, remember. The White City Fighting. Remember, remember.
Down to the refuge in QPR. I drive to confess
in my German car.
Born to violence, born to shame. I cried in silence, I cried in vain. But no one remembers.
Not that I can see that we were defenders. We were the free.
It's one of those tunes, it's hard to
remember, remember.
All right, that's hard to cut off. I like that song a lot. Here's a picture of Dave Gilmore right there. Probably mid-70s. Anyway, all right, White City, a novel. It's an album by Pete Townsend, you know, after The Who broke up. And I really recommend it. I like it a lot. It's got a lot of different styles on it. Pete Townsend's genius shines through once again, like it does on many albums. You know, it sounds dated, but not overly so. I mean, it's still listenable. I mean, but it still sounds like an album from the 80s. But the songs are so good, and the creativity is so nice that you can easily get over that dated sound. And maybe you like that dated sound anyway. I mean, I do. I like a lot of 80s snare drum, like three times as loud as it should be. Anyway, I recommend it. Go buy it. I've always had it in my collection since the 80s, and I pop it in like maybe once a year. So yeah, it brings back a lot of good memories. And I love The Who, love Pete Townsend. So yeah, go buy it. This is Frosty the Songman from Red Radio Reviews, November 25th, 2018. Thanks a lot for listening and watching. Please subscribe to my channel. And I'll try to do... Sorry I'm not doing many videos. I actually just quit my job, and I'm looking for a new job. So I'm kind of in a stressful transition period right now. But yeah, I'll keep doing these videos. I got a lot of CDs to go still. All right, thanks.